So welcome to the class, and in this we are going to do measures that will correct either excess demand or deficient demand and all of it, which means the disequilibrium in the economy, how will it be corrected. So the government, the economy has two types of measures. One is a fiscal measure and the other is a monetary measure. What is a fiscal measure? Fiscal measures are the budgetary policy of the government, which entails expenditure and taxation. And when you're talking about the monetary policy, it is by the central bank of the country. It has quantitative methods as well as qualitative methods. So accordingly, if it's inflation, it uses these two measures in a different manner, from a different angle, and if there is a deflationary situation, another. So inflation in another sense. So that we will do in detail, but I just want you to see this flowchart, and I'm just going to repeat it once again for your benefit, that these are the remedial measures. So there are fundamental policies, the two main policies through which government can intervene in functioning of the economy, and they are fiscal policy and monetary policy. So in the fiscal policy, what we have is fiscal policy is a expenditure policy and the revenue policy of the government to control the supply of money. Aggregate demand has to be increased by an amount equal to deflationary gap, and aggregate demand has to be decreased by an amount equal to the inflationary gap. So how does it do that? It is by government expenditure, increase or decrease, taxes, increase or decrease. We will do that in detail. We'll take it for each one of them. So again, in monetary measures, what are monetary measures? Monetary measures or monetary policy, the policy of the central bank of a country to control the credit or the money supply. We've done it earlier, and this would just be the repetition, which we will do it anyway in the ensuing classes. So the measures which are undertaken by the central bank, they are classified into two groups. One is the quantitative method and the other is the qualitative method. So quantitative methods are, they regulate the volume of credit and money supply in total, everywhere. Everybody in, there is no specified policy for a specified sector. It is across the board, everybody treated as equal. And we have what is known as a qualitative method. So these are the selective credit control measures of the in the monetary policy or the central bank. So they aim at regulating the direction or the use of credit, that is, who should get more credit and who should not, and what is the welfare motive and what is the employment generation, or who should get the subsidies and so on and so forth. So in the quantitative measures, we have what is known as bank rate, then open market operations, and we have what is known as legal reserve ratio. And of course, in legal reserve ratio, we have cash reserve ratio and the SLR, statutory liquidity ratio. Now in the qualitative methods, we have margin requirements as in the difference between the value of security and the amount of loan, that is known as margin requirement. Then moral suasion is something like persuasion, just telling the banks what to do, commercial, directing them, cajoling them, telling them this will be good in the inflationary policy, or this will be good in the deflationary policy, or you should go along like this. And of course, you have what is known as the selective credit controls in the consumer credits. Okay, so this is what we will be doing, and measures to control this.